Hi everyone, my name is Leah Kopke and I'm a 3D motion design freelancer. I also have a podcast where each week I cover another 3D modeling tool for Cinema 4D. Hello and welcome! Today we're going to go over the Symmetrize tool. Last week we went over the Symmetry tool for Cinema 4D. I'm really excited to show you the details of Symmetrize and the options that go along with it. It's super helpful. So let's go ahead and jump into Cinema 4D and get started. So last week we went over the Symmetry tool over here. You can see Enable Symmetry as well as the Symmetry settings over here. You can find these tools in the Mesh menu under Clone. You'll see Symmetrize as well as Symmetry up here. They're a little bit different. They look a little bit different. They both have this gear icon that comes with a series of options, and it helps you make your mesh symmetrical. If you're ever trying to work on something that's symmetrical and it accidentally gets messed up and it's no longer symmetrical, this is a really easy, quick fix to get you back on the right path. So let's talk a little bit about the settings in here. By default, this link with hub is turned on. If you're wondering what are they talking about when they say hub, they're talking about your symmetry settings over here. So this is your symmetry hub. That's what they're referencing within the Symmetrize settings. We went over many of these settings last week. They do overlap with this little bit, so I'll keep this to a minimum explaining them, but let's talk about this link with hub. So you have the option of planar or radial for Symmetrize, and just to give you an example of planar, let's go ahead and drop a cube in here. I'm going to hit the C key to make it editable. You can also hit this icon over here to make it editable. And once we do that, we can now edit it with our mesh modeling tools. I just turned on garage shading lines from our display menu over here, so that's a lot easier to work with. I'm going to change from model mode to polygon mode so that we can select these polygons and extrude them using the hotkey MT. I'll leave a link to the episode on the extrude tool in case if you're interested in learning more. So I'll go ahead and click and drag my mouse on that polygon and it'll extrude it. I'm going to hit the R key for rotate, hold down shift to use the quantize. I'll also leave a link if you're interested in learning about that tool in the description. And then I'll use MT again in order to extrude this. So now we have a very asymmetrical object. What if we wanted this to be symmetrical? Well, that's where the Symmetrize comes in handy. So let's go ahead and just press this button here. Now it's symmetrical, that's very helpful. And then if you want to start off where you left off before, you can turn back on symmetry as we've gone over before, and you can continue 3D modeling. I'm going to hit undo a few times and we're going to go back to where we started so that we can talk about some of these settings. I'll leave it right here. I'm going to turn off the symmetry tool. Let's take a look in here. We'll go over planar first. Link with hub will borrow the settings from in here. If I turn this off, you can set these manually. Now you'll remember the space option we went over last time. It determines what axis you're using for the symmetry. Your local axis is the axis of the object you are modeling. The global axis is the origin, and it uses the origin's coordinates in order to create the symmetry. You can use the work plane. There's a whole other episode on the work plane, and you can customize that and move it around for your 3D modeling needs. I'll leave that in the link below. And then you can also choose custom and enter in your own coordinates for this to be symmetrical around. You can choose what plane you are using for the symmetrize, and you can use the X plane, the Y, the Z, and you can use more than one at once. So 3D is a grid. You have a grid in here. So we can see the top view, the front view, and the right view. So it gets into math a little bit. But what you want to keep in mind is that, well, let's say for instance you're using the global settings or something like that. Or in this case, this is 000 as our custom position in here. So that would mean that this is the center axis. And then if we rotate around the X, you can see in here that this is the X direction on our gizmo here. So that means that from point zero, which is right here, and going this way, it's a positive number. From zero going this way, it's a negative X value. So it's like a graph or a grid, basically. And the same goes for the Y direction or the Z direction. So that's something to keep in mind for this. So when it says positive X to positive Y to negative X, positive X to negative X, when it says that here, it's saying that it will grab the symmetry from this side and it will duplicate it over to the negative side. So that's what we did before. So if I hit OK, you'll see that that looks like that, as you'd expect. It took the positive and copied that over to the negative to make it a symmetrical object. I'm going to hit undo so that we can talk more about these settings. So this is helpful for if you 3D model an arm of a character and you want it to be on the other side, or a leg of a character and you want it to be on the other side, and you forgot to turn on symmetry. You have these additional options down here. I'm going to change this back to link with hub, and then I'll just use the symmetry options from over here. Now, when it says cut a long plane, that means that when it creates the symmetry, it will create a cut along that center line. So that's what we've been doing this whole time. That means it's going to look like this, and it's going to have this cut along the center so you can see the symmetry. Now, if we turn that off, it will remove that. So I'll uncheck that. I'll hit OK. You can see there's no longer a center line edge determining the center of our symmetry. I'll hit undo there. So we could talk about more of these. Remove outside. So you can see that our object, right now, we are using symmetrize along the axis of this object, and the axis of this object is in the center here. So part of this model is in the negative X, and we're copying the positive X to the negative X. And we have this side here. So what happens to this side when we mirror it? That's what this determines here. So remove outside, when we mirror this, this will remove this side here. So we can click OK. I need to make sure that this cube is selected first, and then I'll try that again. I'll hit OK. Now we've done that. If I go ahead and delete these, you can see that this is hollow on the inside. There's no plane in there, because it removed the outside, and that's what it's referring to as the outside. Now let's show what happens if you don't do that. If you were to uncheck this and hit OK, it'll duplicate that over, but if we delete these polygons again, you'll see that this edge is still there, or this polygon rather. So this is what happens when you don't remove the outside. You end up with some duplicates. You can even see that these walls are duplicates. I have to delete this once and then twice for it to be gone because it overwent that side. I think it's usually just best to leave this on because it prevents errors. You don't really want overlapping geometry, and this is an easy way to solve that. Weld seam. Weld seam works very similar to the weld tool or the optimize tool that we've covered in the past. What it does is it makes sure that points in the center and edges in the center are welded together as one, instead of having two edges overlapping in the same area or two points overlapping in the same area. I'm going to hit undo on this so that we go back to our original object that doesn't have symmetry so that we can continue talking about this. And this tool, by the way, it works for both sculpting and modeling, so it's a great one. Within Symmetrize, you can choose your tolerance here. That's basically the amount of error you're willing to accept for welding the seam together. This means that if two points are 1 centimeter apart, they will be welded together. If they are more than that, they won't be welded together. What does dissolve do? If we turn on the dissolve, points and edges created by the weld seam will be dissolved. So now you can see we no longer have a center line. That center line has been dissolved. Dissolve is also a mesh modeling tool in here. It's listed under remove. And there's also a link to that episode, so I will leave that in the description below so you can learn all of these if you want. We've really covered all the mesh modeling tools already. This is just going more in depth of the Symmetrize. And let's go ahead and take another look at the Symmetrize options. That basically covers it for planar. I'm going to open up a new scene in here so that we can talk about the radial Symmetrize options. I'll change your display to show lines again in here. I'm going to drop in a torus since that is radially symmetrical. We have a pipe. We have pipe segments of 16 and ring segments of 32. I think that's fine for right now. And we're going to make this editable using the C-hat key so that we can use the mesh modeling tools on it, including Symmetrize. So, Symmetrize, let's go ahead and make sure that we have this from our clone menu. I'm just going to click this bar up here so that this becomes separate once again. And we can see that we have different radial symmetry options in here. Link to hub will use the settings from our symmetry hub that we talked about earlier for things like the space, where this is being made symmetrical from, the local axis, global coordinate system, work plane, or custom point. Very similar to the planar. You can choose what axis is being used for the radial symmetry. Is it radially symmetrical along the X, Y, or Z? What is the rotation offset? You can offset the rotation of the symmetry. What is your slice count? That's the number of slices for the radial symmetry. Mirror mirrors each slice individually, and the source slice is the slice that's going to be used for the symmetry. So that was a lot of information that I went through quickly, but the Symmetrize, we can choose to link this to the hub, and with that it'll be using the symmetry options from the symmetry hub. So let's turn on symmetry, let's turn on radial, and let's switch to polygon mode. so we can see what's happening in here. And just briefly, let's just visually show these settings real quick. For those who are new, it'll take a few seconds. So axis, X, Y, Z. Now you can see it better since we have polygon mode on and we're looking at the symmetry settings in the symmetry hub. You can choose your rotation offset. That rotates it. I'll set it back to 0. You can choose your source slice. And your source slice will be visualized by this arrow here. So what this means is that if we were to use Symmetrize on this, it would use this slice here. You may be wondering what these blue slices are. So let's talk about that. What those blue planes are. So those are actually mirroring each slice. So right now we have 6 slices. I'll increase this to 8, that's the number of slices. And then the mirror actually mirrors changes from each slice. So you could have symmetry along each individual slice, not just radial symmetry. So that's what the mirror controls. Your source slice will be the one referenced. If you increase this number, it'll go to the next one. So this is just which slice are we referencing for the symmetry. Let's set this back to the default of 0. So in order for the Symmetrize to work with the symmetry, it helps to have your symmetry enabled because it's referencing the hub there. In our case, our source slice is 8. The cut along plane setting is the same as planar. Remove outside is the same as planar. Weld seam is the same as planar. Tolerance, dissolve, all those settings you know. Let's try something. Before we use this, let's actually make this asymmetrical. So I'm going to turn off the symmetry for right now. And this looks about where our slices. So I'm going to just extrude this and let's go on back over here. Enabler symmetry. Now this is no longer symmetrical, but we can go into Symmetrize and use radial and use this source of 8 and hit OK. Now you can see that it's symmetrical all the way around. Now it seems like it's run into a little bit of an error here, so let's hit undo and see what we can do about that. Perhaps turning off dissolve will help. I'll hit OK. So that looks better. So that's why it's good to be familiar with the settings. Sometimes you can run into errors using the Symmetrize, but if you know what each one of those settings are, it's a lot easier to troubleshoot them. So I really hope you found this helpful. That pretty much covers Symmetrize for today. It's a really helpful tool for both sculpting and mesh modeling because there are so many objects in the world that are symmetrical. So it's a really common workflow to use one of these tools. We go for another 3D modeling tool each week, and I hope you'll stay tuned for next week. And I look forward to seeing you then. Thank you so much for 3D modeling with me.